Hi, it's Marcy Gevril with Yoga of Touch, using your own human resources for self-healing, your own heart, hands, and head. Today's lesson is to clear the chest for the ribs and the lungs and the breasts. It applies to men and women. Make sure you learn about the face and the chest and the belly because they're all connected.
More about melting touch in my book, Feel Like Yourself Again, at yogaoftouch.com. Download the free flashcards that remind you how to do the belly, chest, and head in 6 simple steps. Today, you need to also do the belly melt. Check it out on YouTube. We will be learning the chest melt, especially for the respiratory system, the lungs, mucus, breathing, anything to do with digestion. Very important to open this all up and send it down to the colon. Face melt is covered on YouTube as well in a separate video. Let's do the 5 keys for healing and transformation in the yoga of touch. Bring awareness to your body and deep breathing. Allow a good intention for healing and the movement that goes along with that. Don't forget to bring in sound for the emotional component and express yourself. It's important to open up the entire alimentary canal. Wake the snake of the food tube with peristalsis, a very gentle, slow, rhythmic pulsing that begins at the back of the throat, follows down through the thoracic cavity, landing at the stomach area, and down through the descending colon. Making a laundry chute for the debris that must fall into the colon, down through the mucosa. See the goggles T-shape and circular clockwise pathway of this melting touch method in my book. Send a pulse from the throat to the stomach, and it turns out the new research confirms that the connection is in the brain. The lymphatic vessel in the brain is now known to connect with the thoracic duct in the lower part of the body, and this is what I'm teaching for many, many years, to open up the throat and the thoracic duct so that all this semi-solid debris can fall into what my teacher Lauren Berry described as a spleen release into the colon. I call it the waterfall. You'll feel material and debris landing in the descending colon, the left side, down by that left hip bone. That's why it's important to begin with the ocean wave for colon peristalsis. It's like a frisbee going around on its edge. You can do one section at a time. Left hip bone, left rib cage, right rib cage to left hip bone, and then right hip bone all the way around in a clockwise direction, shaking at the diaphragm. Following the melting touch method, you'll see in my book, shows the deep channels for the mucus drainage pathway. This will help drain the lungs at the diaphragm, hug myself, pressing into the rib cage, drawing each little river, draining from the sides to the center, all the way towards the thoracic duct, which is in the center under the sternum. This is where the debris is sent downward towards the colon and the clean fluid upward towards the subclavian. Now squish the soapy sponge underneath the armpits. The nodes there are easy to get activated and activate the neurolymphatic points at each rib where they're attached to the sternum open up the intercostal spaces, drawing down, squeegee, slide down the neck towards the subclavian, and bring everything again towards that center line. Same thing on the right side, bringing it towards the center line from around the back, and make sure you again squish the soapy sponge underneath the armpits in the nodes, a cluster of nodes there, very slow, rhythmic waltz, and pressing on the pectoral muscle, you can pump in a very slow waltz rhythm to drain the lungs, and using your fingers like little Swiffer machines, pressing into the intercostal spaces to move the debris into the thoracic duct where semi-solids can be taken down to the colon and the clean fluids will be taken back up to the subclavian. Using a myofascial approach, slowly move your hands away from each other, elongation, to open up the thoracic duct and move debris down and clean fluid upward. A little shimmy shake and a little diagonal movement. You can optionally use a mini trampoline approach by pressing the fingers and letting them spring up. Press and spring up. This will open up the lungs. Sometimes it might make you cough or sputter a little. Slow, gentle breaths with rhythmic pulsing. This you can also do for the liver over on the right side, right at the rib cage. Give it a little press. And then again, hug myself towards the center and shake the muddy bucket just below the rib cage. This opens up the thoracic duct and the diaphragm connection. Use a hula hand and bring the debris down from the spleen towards the descending colon. Again, this is a T shape from the back to the front, from the sides to the center, and coming down the ribs at the sternum, bringing semi-solids down towards the colon, bringing that down towards the spleen and the descending colon, giving it a little shake to loosen it up. That's the semi-solids going downward from the sternum. Again, the clean fluid is moving upward towards the subclavian, doing your gentle butterfly circles at the subclavian. Get more details about the face melt from my YouTube video. Also, download a free card from my website that helps you remind yourself of what to do for the face massage. Let's do a complete sweep from the head all the way to the colon and make sure you're using all the areas we've gone over, the eyes, the cheeks, the jawline, the face melt, and now the chest melt, everything down through the center and down to the colon. And that's a wonderful detox. Using your five keys for healing and transformation with Marcy Gevril, your vitality expert.